है प्लांट प्रोपागेशन. फर्स्ट प्रोपागेशन मीन्स मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ प्लांट विथ एम टू अचीव इंक्रीज इन नंबर एंड प्रिजर्व द इसेंशियल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द मदर प्लांट. ओके, सो फर्स्ट प्रोपागेशन मीन्स मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स विथ एम टू इंक्रीज और अचीव द नंबर ऑफ नंबर एंड प्रिजर्व द इसेंशियल मदर प्लांट्स. So there are two types of propagation. First is a sexual propagation and next one is the asexual propagation. First, sexual propagation. Sexual reproduction refers to multiplication of plants by seed. Okay. Multiplication of plants by seed is called as sexual propagation. Seeds are formed after successful pollination and fertilization by the union of male and female gametes. This is called as sexual propagation. That means the success is depends on fertilization or by the union of male and female gametes. The plants raised through seeds are called as seedling plants. Advantages of sexual propagation is sexual method of propagation has several advantages, like propagation by seed is a simple and easy method of propagation. Seed propagation only mean of diversity, particularly in the selection of chance seedlings. That means through the sexual propagation we can produce same as like a mother plants. Plants can be produce same as like mother plant. Seedling plants are long-lived, productive, and have a greater tolerance to adverse soil and climatic condition and disease. So this is the those plants are produced from the sexual propagation. That plants having long life. That means and the productive life, and also it's having a good tolerance as compared to the asexual propagation. That plants can be withstand in any adverse climatic conditions. Seed propagation make feasible to propagate plants like papaya and coconut, in which asexual means of propagation is not common or not practiced. Propagation through seeds or papaya, the papaya plants or the stem is hollow stem. So that's why in the papaya cultivation, asexual propagation cannot be possible. And in also coconut. So that's why the seed propagation is very essential in papaya and coconut. Hybrids can only be developed by sexual means. Sexual propagation offers opportunities of polyembryo, citrus, mango or jamun and apomixis. This is the some fruit crops having polyembryony condition. That means the number of embryos present in a single seed, that is called as polyembryony. Seed, citrus, mango and jamun. These fruit plants having a polyembryony condition, that means the multiplication of plants through a single seeds can be possible. Then apomixis, malus sicimnis, then Malus halpensis, Malus sargenti. This is the apple species which produce two type of plants. Seed is the source of production of rootstock for sexual propagation. For the asexual propagation, we use a rootstock, and that rootstock can be produced only through seed propagation. Okay, seeds if stored properly can be kept for longer duration or period for future use. Seed can be kept for can be stored for longer duration. We can say as the conservation of seeds. Okay, the seed can be conserved a longer period, and that can be used for the future period. Okay. Some disadvantages of sexual propagation. Egg seedling plants are not true to type to the mother plant due to the heterozygous nature of fruit plants. Okay, some diversification can be observed in seedling plants. That means the plants cannot be true to type of mother plants. Seedling plants have a long juvenile phase, 6 to 10 years. And hence, flowering and fruiting commences very late. Okay, now trends, we use asexual propagation because those plants are propagated through asexual method that can plants produce or bear the flowering as very early age of the plants. That means only 2 to 3 years or 3 to 5 years required for the bearing of the plants. But the sexual propagation, this phase is very long juvenile phase. It's required 6 to 10 years for the flowering and fruiting. Okay, then sexually raised plants are generally tall and spreading type, and thus are cumbersome for carrying out various management practices like pruning, spraying, and harvesting. Sexually propagated plants are generally tall. Okay, then the spreading type or spreading type, that means the cost of cultivation is more because the pruning is required for the spreading type of plants, and then harvesting is very difficult for the tall plants. Seeds of many fruits are to be sown immediately after extraction from the fruits as they lose their viability very soon. For example, cashew nut, jamun, jackfruit, citrus, mango, and papaya. Some fruits having seeds, some fruits after the harvesting, most of the fruits, for example jamun, mango, jackfruit, cashew nut, etc., and papaya, the seeds having very low less time of viability. The mango seeds having only 3 weeks of viability. If you do late sowing, that the plants or that seeds cannot be germinate because the viability is very low. Only 3 weeks after extraction from the fruits, seed extracted from the fruit. The beneficial influence of rootstock on scion variety cannot be exploited in a sexual propagation. Rootstock and scion compatibility is very important for the propagation. Seedling plants are usually produce fruit of inferior quality. Sometimes through the seed propagation from a single plant, some fruits having like a big size, some fruits are small size, some fruits are medium size. So some fruits having inferior quality and some fruits having export quality fruits can be produced through seedling plants or the seed propagated plants. In vegetative propagation, we can produce a exterior quality of fruits or export quality of fruits. These are the advantages and disadvantages of sexual propagation. Okay, next one is the asexual propagation. Asexual propagation, that means the plants raised through sexual process are identical to the mother plants. Cutting, division, layering, budding, and grafting are the main techniques of asexual propagation. In this method of propagation, we use vegetative plant parts for the propagation. It is a dependent of sexual propagation process that, as there is a no involvement of sex organ. Okay, it takes place due to the mitotic division. Mitotic division continues in shoot tip, root tip, and cambium. Okay, in this method of propagation, tissue culture is also involved. We can use a sheet shoot tip or a single tissue for the propagation, and that can be multiply a number of plants. And in this method of propagation, we use cuttings, layering, budding, grafting, then division, that means rhizomes, tubers, stolon, oocytes, combs, etc. for the propagation. That means in this propagation, male and female plants are not involved. Only vegetative plant parts are used. Okay. Some advantages of asexual propagation. Asexually propagated plants are true two type of their mother plants. Identical plants can be produced from the asexual propagation. Okay. Asexual propagated plants have a short juvenile phase and bear flowers and fruits in the early age, 3 to 4 years, than the seedling plants. Okay. So very short juvenile juvenile phase, the fruit or the plants can bear very early in the age, like 3 to 4 years. The vegetatively propagated plants are similar in structure, and hence management operation like spraying, pruning and harvesting etc. become easy. Through the vegetative propagation, the plants can be produced, some dwarf plants can be produced, that means reduces the cost of cultivation like spraying, pruning and harvesting. Plants in which seed setting does not take place, example pineapple and banana, sexual propagation serves as the substitute for asexual propagation serves as the substitute for sexual propagation. Banana and pineapple cannot set the seeds. So in banana and pineapple, we can only have a use to asexual propagation. Using asexual method, desirable characters of mother plants can be perpetuated or the multiplied easily. Okay. The multiplication is very easy in asexual propagation. The benefit of rootstock and scion are usually exploited through asexual propagation. Repairing of damaged portion of the plants is possible through asexual propagation in case of bridge grafting. This is the one of the method of grafting. In this grafting method, we can reuse the plants. If the damage of or the repairing of the damaged plants, we can use bridge grafting. Bridge grafting, that means we can graft on the old plants or damaged plants. We use a scion very early age or less age, that means 3 to 4 months plant scion can be used for the grafting, and that means the damaged plants can be converted into productive plants. Okay. Then rejuvenation can be done in asexual propagation. That means we can increase the productive life of the plants. If it is possible to convert non-productive local variety into a productive improved variety by asexual methods, then it is possible to grow several varieties in one plant or change variety of existing plants by top working. This is another method of grafting, top working. In this method we can use a number of varieties on a single plant. Okay. For example, the variety of Alfonso. If the plant is unproductive, that time we can use top working method and grafting method on the plants, and different varieties of scion can be used on that plants and can produce a different variety of fruits from the single plant. Okay. Then disadvantages: asexual propagated plants have a shorter lifespan as compared to the sexual propagated plants. Okay. Sexual propagation restrict diversity. Sometimes asexual propagation disseminate disease like Tristeza virus in a citrus. through the sexual propagation, dissemination of disease, okay, spreading of disease, chances is very high. For the asexual propagation, technical expertise or skilled labor is required for the carrying out the different grafting, budding and layering operation. So this is all about propagation method.